All right. Good evening. Welcome to the August meeting of the St. Mary's Recreation and Parks Advisory Board. I'd like to call the meeting to order. Our first item on the agenda is to review and approve the minutes from the June meeting. Has everyone had a chance to look at them? Any comments, additions, corrections?
Very accurate.
Great. Hey.
I'll make a motion to accept the minutes as written.
Okay. I'll second that.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
That's unanimous again. Okay. Moving right along. Next item is the athletic field use plan. And Arthur and Tyrone will give us an update on that.
Well, good evening. Thank you for that. Yeah, we've come to you because we want to work with you and work with the youth sports leagues and the citizen regarding the athletic youth plan as it pertains to inclement weather. You know, Tyrone each weekend is, not each weekend, but several weekends a year, he's out there on the fields early deciding if it's too wet to play, standing water, a saturation, whatever the cause. And then we hear from our citizens, we hear from our league presidents, hey, maybe we shouldn't have canceled in the northern end, maybe it rained in the south, and all those different combinations of what it takes to keep safe and safe playing fields, and plus good turf. So what we want to do over the next couple months is, I think I pointed that out in June, is speak to you tonight about what our plan is, what some other counties are doing, and just let that be in your information. Then follow up in the month of September for some of we're inviting our league officials, presidents, coaches to come and let them come to the microphone and let you hear from them some of their concerns, some of their congratulations, and some of their challenges. So Tyrone, what I'd like for you to do now is just go briefly over this front page, and then I'll take the second page of what other counties are doing, and let's talk about what we're currently doing as far as inclement weather policy.
Kind of what we do on weekends in particular, that's when our largest challenge comes. Because we have to make most of the decisions by 5:30 in the morning. So when you make a decision at 5:30 in the morning, by 9 o'clock that could change. But fortunately, a lot of the groups have to have people, they have people coming from the other counties. So to have a person drive from Virginia to here to tell them they got to go back home and after they arrive, we don't want that to happen. So we go through and make the cancellations as a department rep. And I get a lot of support from David, the director, and everybody. You can pretty well see down the bottom, we've been pretty average over the past 4 years as far as what we've done. I didn't even realize we were that consistent, but we've actually done pretty good and didn't even know it. If you notice the 2014, we had 42, 2015 we had 40, 2016 we had 44. I think where the largest problem coming this year is most of our cancellations, we had a lot of them in May. Well, May is when it's really noticeable to people because they've been sitting in the house all winter and they want to get outside. So everybody that had a telephone called to see when we could what we could do to allow them to play. What we did was we narrowed it down to where only the presidents could contact us. And that goes all the way back to when Pat was doing his thing, you know. So. You know, it's not a new policy, it's a consistent policy with what we've always done. We allow room for people to challenge us. If it's to rain up in Pat's area and didn't rain at Chancellor's Run, then we may not cancel Chancellor's Run's games, or we may not cancel the Ridge games, or we may have to cancel all three depending on when it happens. And that's kind of where we are today with our plan. Our plan is really not that much different than any of the other three counties. It's just that a lot of them are playing more often because they have turf fields. We don't have the luxury of turf yet. And I'm not so certain that we even want the luxury of turf because the Bermuda grass seemed to have done well by us. And so that's where we are.
Okay, and if you've seen there, so again, what is the reason coming for you and working here? Because we want to work with our leagues. We think this is a good forum to do that. Let them share their concerns. Plus, we'll be educating the leagues on why we do what we do. It's based on safety, based on keeping the turf ready year-round for other users, because you know, anytime you're on there and compaction, there goes, and then next thing we know, there's budget expenses to getting fields ready. So one of the things we're doing now is trying to relocate more fields for practice areas, so game fields aren't used as often even in a practice time. So I would like you to turn your attention to page 2, though. What's happening around us? What are people doing? Well, if you see in Calvert County, their staff is making the cancellations. The only county that's done by the various sports leagues is Talbot County. Talbot County, Maryland, their various sports leagues, they make the cancellations where they're going to go or not. So where we lay right there with most of them in the surrounding jurisdictions that say the county staff is responsible for making the cancellations. Here this past year, we did hear some from our users that they thought some days that, you know, it really wasn't quite wet enough out there. The fields weren't saturated. We disagree possibly with what your calls are as staff and why you're doing that. So again, we're not saying that our users have a wrong side of it. We want to educate everybody why we do what we do, what our timing is. Can we do better with regard to communication? But if you see here, Tyrone has a good plan here with the phone lines, when they do it, the whys they do it, how people can be contacted and get in touch. Because I think one of the biggest issues with any time of cancellation, whether it's an indoor or an outdoor facility, is based on that communication. I've been told a half hour ago before I got in my car. All those different things. And when people are notified properly, which I think Tyrone does an exceptional job, I think some of the circumstances regarding anxiety and stress over cancellations are mitigated and moved out of the way. But I want you to be able to hear from them here in the month of September, hear from our youth sports leagues and what some of their concerns are and challenges. And then with that, then we'll get a discussion. It might be as late as November, but to get ready for the spring, but October, November, to come up with what we think maybe in concurrence what we're already doing, or maybe some ideas that we share with one another, what we can do better here in St. Mary's County with our youth sports leagues. Is that fair?
Very.
And we'll work that out this fall. Any questions regarding that you want from Tyrone and I right now?
I think Tyrone's done an excellent job with the field. Because remember where they were at 10 years ago? I mean, it was horrible. I mean, there was no grass. People did what they wanted to do, and the policy has matured and really come a long way. I think you guys have done a great job. And Dave's done a great job maintaining them.
I mean, thank you for saying that.
It's all the way around.
What we're going to add to it, too, is the month of September, we're also going to come with the conditions of our fields. We're going to bring photos and the like to show you where we are with conditions, Ms. Murphy, not only just with inclement weather, but what does it look like? So, because our turfs, our fields, has a lot to do with the budget. Because if we need to get where we need to be, and so this is a good time of year to do it as we go into the budget cycle of what we need to do regarding overseeding equipment, compaction, aeration, and all those things that are to do with it.
I like to add, you know, in the communication part, I've seen as a user with my kids, Charles done a tremendous job. I mean, I don't find any excuses why you don't know ahead of time in a timely manner. It's done with electronic media. It's done a real good job. I would like to explore the idea, Art, you mentioned using the practice facilities versus game fields, because mm-hmm. it's been my experience that if you're using those fields all the time for every aspect of it, they're not going to be able to sustain that over time. So, you know, I'd be interested to know more about that.
Okay, and you're going to hear more about that. Well, let me outline. I'll put these in some of my projects and reports, but let me outline some of those right now. Two of those, since you asked. On September 26th, we're going to have a ribbon cutting at Lancaster Park, and certainly each one of you invited and would like for you to be there. Mr. Heibel, that includes, I know the school day's tough, but we'd love to have you there for sure. The commissioners will be there. They're having a State of the County luncheon at the Bay District Firehouse, and then we'll move right over to Lancaster with you as a board and league volunteers and others that can make it. But Lancaster just put on two full-size, multi-purpose regulation fields. And the reason for that, Tyrone, is so that we can move sports and athletes around and be on there for practice. 120 space parking lot, if you haven't been by, with trails that tie the park in together. Excellent, excellent new addition to Lancaster Park. And then this year in the CIP budget is lighting for one of those fields, and next year another one will be lit. So anytime, especially in our, in the football and soccer arena, you can get lit fields beginning in October. So that, because what happens, a lot of times you have fields on game fields, Mr. Heidel, and then everybody has to go there in October. But now with those multi-purpose there, you can have practice on those areas. So the county's been enriched and blessed by our commissioners and the staff to be able to have those amenities that we can start moving around. And one more, having said that, is Tyrone and I have been meeting with the Wildcats Football Club here at Dorsey Park. And currently in this CIP for FY18 is improvements to that turf field at Dorsey. Now what's happening there are wells coming in, irrigation's coming in since water's being there, and then we're going to be sprigging and seeding that field with Bermuda grass. So that's, but here's the challenge. You can do all of that, but if you have six teams on there 4 to 5 nights a week, that turf can't stand it.
Right.
Tyrone's doing a super job relocating in some outfields and some other areas, and that's why even the thought of moving quick here, potentially, I don't want to get the cart too far ahead, but here we're going back to work at least on engineering design at the Leonardtown Park. Just beginning to start that again, because you know the Garvey Senior Center and the library have been sited there at, in the land, the former Hayden property in front of Duke Elementary School. And now we're going back with the architect and design work to see how we can pot maybe a couple multi-purpose fields there to bring off some of that use there at Dorsey Park.
Good.
So those are in the plans, but Lancaster Park's not in the plans. There's a ribbon cutting coming. You guys need to be there. It's going to be an exciting afternoon in September, I'm telling you. And I'm inviting the community as well. That's a great addition in that Lexington Park area.
Is that going to be part of the commissioners' meeting?
Yes, they're going to be here. Then they're going to shift to the state of the county at the Bay District, and then go right to 2:00 to Lancaster Park.
2:00.
2:00.
Okay.
On September 26th.
I'll be there.
Oh man, I hear that from you, Mr. Howard. I like that.
Right. Not, right now.
It's not a far ride from Western Field either.
No traffic.
Come on, Tyler. We can get more.
It's easy. You're going to have refreshments.
Indeed.
I'll be there.
I'll take them personally for you, Mr. Buckler. It'd be a good day for a good showing for that park in the Lexington Park area. And I'm going to tell you, with the tie-ins, with the side, now with when the parks come in nowadays with the sidewalks and those type of amenities and getting people out, children safely from the cars and the parking areas and the tie-ins with the trails, and it gets it all, the pathway right over to the dog park. Man, did it open up Lancaster Park to be a very, very nice amenity for the county. Proud of that one. We're going to cut the ribbon on it on the 26th.
You put pickleball courts into Lancaster?
Tyrone, do we have pickleball courts there?
It's coming.
They're on their back.
12.
Didn't
they?
Yeah.
They're grass.
Jim Teague, the community.
You say back burner?
Back burner, yeah.
With back the tennis courts.
There's no
behind the tennis courts. Yeah,
we have basketball courts there. And we're going to be with Lancaster Park and Nicollet Park, I think, get resurfacing there this year as well. I know we have two courts that do this year. Okay, I think so. We up to speed on fields and where we want to go there. I got a little ahead there in sending out that illustrious invitation, but I got excited.
Very good.
Mr. Chairman, back to you.
Okay. Well, the
Mr. Chairman, I think we should recognize what happened this week for Mr. Shepherd as well.
Oh.
He's a
very good point.
He's no longer the interim director.
Oh, that's right.
And that's right.
He's a director.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
I'm excited.
We'll kind of miss that in the opening.
We've been.
I think the county, the management of the county made a great decision there.
I do too. I agree with you totally.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Murphy. Appreciate it. Yeah, this is my home. This is my community. So be a part of some of these projects is exciting for me.
It is.
Very exciting.
It is for us too.
Thanks.
We've been taking it easy on you.
Yeah, the honeymoon's over. I think. We're doing good.
At least hope we can keep convince Tyrone to stay around for a few more years.
Oh, there's a couple I'm going to have to do that with. Mr. Murphy, there's a couple.
All righty. The next item on the agenda is project updates. Art?
Okay, so I can let Mr. Harris go. Let's go with the one of our newest addition and what happened this weekend at Snow Hill Park.
Well, Snow Hill Park was actually a wonderful weekend. We started on for not understanding if it was going to be good or not. Everybody had told us how good it was. I talked to the division manager for our section, and she told me it had 17,000 hits, which is incredible.
Oh, you're kidding.
17,000 hits.
Wow.
We've never did anything like that ever before. It's a wonderful park. This weekend, we had 135 paid people.
Paid vehicles.
Vehicles. We had 400 and some odd people that come through. Now, certainly we let vehicles come through to just visit, look at the site and everything, just because they wanted to see. So we didn't charge them to come in to see. They just come in and do their little turnaround and look around. Some of the Amish even come up. They actually bought us a new thing that we need to look into while they were there. So we learned a lot. We learned a lot this weekend. It was a very, very good weekend for us. Staff loves it. Before, I couldn't get anybody to work it. I'm fighting them to get off of it. So that's been very helpful. It was a good project.
Well, let me put it into contrast. The week before, I stopped in the first week that we opened, and it was one of our hotter weekends of the year. And then and we had, over the weekend, about 40 cars in the 2 days. So we really didn't know what to expect. But remember this past Sunday, what a wonderful low humid day that was, and allowed people just there. Because really right now, what you have at the park, well, the park staff did an excellent job with the ticket gate there. Then the signage, the parking area, the handicap parking area, the grass, the combing of the beach. So really it's just right now, a place to access the water with a kayak or canoe. Their picnic area, shade. But this past weekend, the families enjoyed it incredibly, and just to have it open like that.
Yeah.
Just so that the community, who it is their asset, the citizens' asset, they can come give it a view and plus have a family there. Roslyn Creek over there, did anybody ever launch or go in there for a...
We had two people.
Did they?
Yes.
Yeah, because part of that property, you go over that creek side. I think, Ms. Warren, you're over there. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And you can get a kayak in there, but there's just so much potential there. But now, where are we? That's one of the things I want to talk to you about with Snow Hill. Where are we there? But still, at this point in time, there is no funding yet for any type of master plan or architect and engineering. But I'm sure that's going to... I hope and confident that's going to come so we can begin to move the process along. But remember, that was purchased with program open space money, state money from the transfer tax, and also the Navy, the REPI money for encroachment. They invest in there. And we just went to settlement, was that last Friday? With the United States Navy, so that's been taken care of. But with their involvement too, remember that allows us there to only be an active and passive recreation park. So think about all the things, and most of the people I'm hearing from our feedback is they're looking for that boat launch access on the Patuxent River. Mm-hmm. And so we're gearing toward a passive and active park. We're gonna be done in the weekends of 1st of October. Some people want to know why. Well, one of the reasons why, well, the days are shortened and the temperatures, but also gives us a chance to step back again and manage, because we also know that we want to maybe put some new things in, nothing major, but some soft things in to open up for the spring. But man, to think on the second weekend, over 130 some cars in Snow Hill Park.
That's
when the amenities just aren't there, except for this great, you know, this great view that most of you saw the last meeting we had. So Snow Hill's well on its way, which leads me in a segue into our land preservation and recreation plan. That is going to go before the county commissioners, we hope, on August the 22nd for their approval. And then a lot of different things happen once the state gets that plan with the commissioner's approval. Kathy's done just can't tell you the stupendous job that she does with that, with the details, with working with the state, the consultant, and all those to get this ready. And really, the Land Preservation Parks and Recreation Plan, it serves two purposes. It gives us our inventory. We know what we have. You as an advisory board know what you can lean on to support the data and the statistics of what's here, how many tennis courts, pickleball courts, 90-foot diamonds, 60-foot diamonds, beach at water access, public boat rental, all that's there. And then the second part is, this is part of the 5-year cycle to get that program open space money. And that decide, you know, you have to be a part of that. And then when Snow Hill opened, that gave us that access to the water. That now put us, in that quick opening, put us at a place where we could
that we are in a better place to meet our land acquisition goals for the state.
So that, yeah, that upped it with our land acquisition goals. And when you up the land acquisition goals, that means you can use your money and gives you more flexibility with the use of that program open space money. So we're proud of that too. A park that was acquired in March and the opening now to be a part of the land preservation and recreation plan, that allows us more flexibility with funding and gets our acquisition goals possibly there. But it's still a possible. But next time we meet, we'd probably be able to confirm it, okay? So we're excited about that, which leads us to that one, that Elms Beach plan you approved at the last meeting. That will go on board the 29th of commissioners be before them, and hope we get a concurrence and a vote of that on the Elms Beach master plan. You've heard about Lancaster Park. You've heard about Dorsey Park, what's going on there. Tomorrow we meet with the consultant with the our folks for the three-notch trail from Wildwood to Leonardtown Hollywood Road, Route 245. We're going to have a meeting inside about with Public Works staff, John Groger, about stormwater management. Some of the terrain has more dips than, you know, originally anticipated, and all the things you have to discuss for siting it. And then we're also going to have a walk and drive by meeting of the trail. So that's it, the steps, the process is beginning to get moving forward. So we're definitely excited there, because, you know, your other sections through six now gives us an 11 miles in the North County. So a biker can now have a 22 mile down and back. That's pretty significant. Yeah. Pretty significant to get going.
Is the Route 4 235 intersection area part of that discussion for tomorrow?
No. No. We're talking about right there at the Airport Road, right there.
Okay.
Yeah. As you
Wildwood area.
Yeah, the Wildwood area at that Airport Drive.
The section stops right there, I think, at that intersection.
That's where it's going to stop on this 57. Okay. Mm-hmm. So a lot happened there. One thing that something normally noted here is we have a museum director has it accepted the offer. Now, I can't mention who that is or who they're from yet, because they have to go through pre-employment background screening and all that, but certainly you'll get the information and see the press release. But, you know, we've been out a museum manager since last June.
We're not going to tell anybody. Go ahead.
Since last year, Mr. Butler, that was good. So, but so we have somebody who accepted the offer, so we're beginning to get excited that soon we'll be able to make that announcement through a press release that there's a new museum manager within the department. Lastly, I have two other things. Remember, when I first arrived, we were gymnastics was hot. What's going on with the gymnastics? I mean, we've had some discussions there. Last night, I was just there meeting with the parents and the boosters group, and I can honestly say that's one of the better gymnastics meetings I've been a part of in my 25 to 30 years of meeting with the club. You have a group of parents that now are ready for a fresh restart. They're investing. They're into it. We met with an ad hoc group for over seven or eight meetings. We had the coaching staff meet, and the commissioners agreed to the plan of action where we now have given some salary increases to our hourly coaching staff to better recruit and retain. We hired a new program director to be there through that entire afternoon and evening shift to bring some stability and communication there. And certainly Recreation Division Manager Jessica Hale and our coordinator Kyle Keyball, they stood in that gap there, and they got back after with some hard work. So we have an exciting program at the Gymnastics Center now. We're close to 500 in the recreation program. We have shared use with the cheerleading athletes along with the gymnastics. Everybody's gotten along and brought that to pass. So I'm very excited about the gymnastics program now, and especially after what I saw last night. And then what brings us to that last one is cheerleading. You know, cheerleading has over 100 and some athletes registered in that sport now. They like to compete. They go away to meets. They need a spring floor. So we continually meet with them. But the first thing we did is we got them a good schedule at the gymnastics center so that they have a floor. They can work out there. We're also now working on doing some small things at the Carver Recreation Center. That's their home base. That's where they began. And what we can do there working with them. And then we're also now working out for the last piece is that affiliation with the department and what that all means. So I'll be meeting with them in a couple weeks, and I think we can hash all that out with staff, and I think the cheerleaders are going to have a safe landing here soon too. I think.
Is that an enterprise fund?
Yes.
Activity?
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Gymnastic center, cheerleading, they're all enterprise activities, registration fees, paying for the cost of operating those programs.
But the cheerleaders is really taken off. They have a strong leader, you know, foundational leadership and want to support them.
I think we're off to, well, not a good start. They've been there a while, but we're now building a good foundation that can support them. Because what happens sometimes in recreation, you have something that's leader-driven. If you have a good person behind it, it's going to succeed. But then you have to get it to a point where that foundation, that no matter who the leader is, it's sustaining for the families, and it's here 5, 10, 15 years. And that's where we're heading, I think. And I think we're going to have a good grasp on that. That's my updates. Am I missing anything?
I don't think so.
Tim?
I think you got it.
Good update. Any questions? Yeah. All right. Next item is other business. Is there any other business?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Doesn't look like it. Okay. Any motion to adjourn?
I make a motion to adjourn.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.
No, glad you. Then the